not a summit. It was a Make America Great rally. They used some young blacks as props, which really is an insult to them.
Those vile remarks by Al Sharpton were directed at the attendees of Turning Point USA's Young Black Leadership Summit, where President Trump gave a speech last week. Now, here to react is Horace Cooper, co-chair of Project 21. Horace, it seems that the Reverend Al believes that only Democrats should have the monopoly on outreach to African Americans. I found that, I've got to say, well, I shouldn't be surprised, but it was still despicable.
Not just the monopoly on outreach, also the monopoly on the use of bigoted and racist remarks with every single group. He didn't just attack Kanye West and other moderate blacks. He's attacked gays. He's attacked Asians, both Chinese and Koreans. It's his vile language that refers to people who are Jewish as diamond merchant. These are the kinds of comments that a man like this makes, and then he wants to stand up and say he should be the arbiter of what constitutes racism and what doesn't. My group, Project 21, was created precisely because we want to make sure people understand that black Americans aren't identified by our skin color. We all have individual views, opinions. We can be Democrats, we can be Republicans. He's none of those things. He's just a bigot.
To your point, Horace, MSNBC trotted out Al Sharpton this weekend to react to the Pittsburgh tragedy. Was that a wise decision given his ugly history of comments about people of the Jewish faith? Let's watch.
We must equally be outraged with the Tree of Life 11 and say that there is no room for bigotry anywhere.
No room for bigotry anywhere. Well, I would agree with him on that, but why does that not apply to some of his past statements?
I mean, here's the guy who's the poster child, not for a dog whistle, for coming right out and using the most vile and bigoted remarks, and he targets people all the time. When it was Don Imus who came on his program and wanted to apologize for the bigoted remarks that he had made, his response was, you can't be a purveyor on the national airwaves if you're making comments like this. And yet there he sits on MSNBC.
Well, a lot of corporate types like to, and they want to play nice with Al Sharpton, because if they do play nice with Al Sharpton, they won't get hauled in or sued, or they won't be harassed by him. I think that's part of it as well. But to say that black youth that were at that Turning Point summit were used, that's an insult to their intelligence. They were there because they wanted to be. Horace, thanks so much.